Will robots feel or ever have emotions? Hi, I'm Dr Eleanor Sandry, and I'm from Media, Creative Arts and Social Inquiry at Curtin University. I work in the humanities, and I'm interested in human-robot interactions. And in particular, actually, I've been interested for a long time in the idea of social robots. Broadly, robots are designed to feel. But they're designed to feel in terms of being able to sense the world around them such that they can behave in ways that respond to that world. Now, when we're thinking about this sort of question, though, we're actually thinking about emotions and emotional feelings. One way to do that is to consider how emotions are really to do with expressing oneself. And so the external expression, if you like, that someone else can read. Whereas feelings are probably best considered as something internalized, so within the body. There have already been quite a few examples of robots that are designed to express emotions. The first social robot was called Kismet, designed at Massachusetts Institute of Technology by Cynthia Brazil. While these robots can express emotion, and therefore seem to have emotions, broadly underlying this, there are no feelings in those robots. They may look sad, but they don't feel sad. And it seems very likely that in the future, robots probably won't be able to have feelings in a way that we might directly understand at all. It can be really useful to think about science fiction examples in order to kind of get a grip on the ideas of robots and emotions and feelings. One particularly good example for thinking through is Lieutenant Commander Data in Star Trek: The Next Generation. So Data is a character, an android, so a very humanoid robot member of the Starship Enterprise crew. And yet, when you look at the details, you can see that Data becomes increasingly able to express emotions in human-like ways, given the situation that he finds himself in. However, the storyline often revolves around the fact that even though Data is expressing something, he doesn't have underlying feelings. He doesn't have anything within his body to draw upon when he's making those responses. And that is only further complicated by the location of something they call the emotion chip. And yet, of course, the idea behind adding emotion and feeling in this deep kind of way to an android like Data is to allow Data to fit in better with the crew and also to be able to make decisions on the basis of the feelings that he has. Moving back to real life then, robots are often made to express for exactly the same sorts of reasons that I've just been talking about in science fiction, to help them to fit into human social situations. And underlying this, the idea of feelings in these robots is still very much an unknown and very unlikely to be included into the future.